What's up, Terabytes? I'm Tara with Tara Simon Studios, and it is Throne Room Confession Day. Today, I want to talk to you about the cost of calling. And first, before you know about calling, you need to know that salvation is something that's free to us, right? It doesn't cost us anything, but it cost Jesus everything. And that's free. All you have to do is accept what he did and accept him into your heart, and there is zero cost for that, right? And you're saved. Yes, hallelujah, right? But there is a cost to calling. There's a difference. There's a difference, a big difference between salvation and calling. Salvation saves you. Calling is what you do here on earth. It's what God calls you to do. And everybody, by the way, is entitled to a calling. If you're a child of God, you are called to something specific. And whether or not you realize that in your life is up to you. And the way that you realize that is understanding that knowing that calling costs you something. When you call on God and ask him to do something through you that's special, you really need to realize that there is a price to pay for that. The more we live the way God is calling us to live, and if you don't know how to live, then read the Bible. It's basically a guideline to that. The more we live in the way God calls us to live, the more presence and power he gives to us. And presence and power is something I want to think about for a second, because when you have the presence of God, which is the Holy Spirit, you are enabled to then understand in a more deepened way exactly where you're supposed to go, what you're supposed to do, who you're supposed to touch in life. So obedience equals presence, this presence of the Holy Spirit, right? Which is wisdom. So obedience equals then wisdom. And wisdom equals power. You've heard the phrase a million times, knowledge is power, right? And to be wise, knowing what we're supposed to be doing and then powerfully execute that is to be effective, right? But it all starts with the root of obedience. You wouldn't give a kid, like I'm a mom, right? So I wouldn't give my five-year-old all of this responsibility if I knew that he had obedience issues. You know, we would need to get that in check first, and then I would be able to call him higher and say, okay, son, now you've done X, Y, and Z, I'm gonna give you this big job to do, because to whom much is given, much is also required, right? And I want you to think in your own life, maybe there's been a time where you've lived disobediently and you can tell, like, your station of influence has been lowered, or maybe you were very obedient and because of your obedience you were able to then see, looking in hindsight, how that affected your life or others' lives in a positive way. I don't know what your calling is. I can only speak for myself, and I know that sometimes obedience really hurts. And it's really not what you want to do, because discipline is the greatest form of self-love, but it is also the most difficult. And I remember obedience being birthed in my life and in my career out of necessity to provide for my family when I was not being provided for. I remember having to be obedient to lesson days and times and working round the clock and be obedient to diligence, being obedient to the bills that I had to pay, being obedient to submitting to what I didn't feel like I should have to at the time, and yet that was the order of things. It didn't sometimes even seem right? But like, I knew that my obedience would be rewarded. I knew that God was watching. I knew that he saw me. And he sees you. He really does. He's everywhere in your midst, and he sees you. And when you're obedient, he rejoices over that. He does reward that. He is a rewarder. And so I just, for those of you out there, if you're saved and you're like, Tara, I really want to be a woman or a man of influence. I really want to impress my parents and honor them, or I really want to end a career well, or I really want to start a career well. I really want to marry and be the best husband or wife I could be. How do I be the best I can be beyond salvation? I know I'm saved, thank you, Jesus, but now what? What's deeper? I challenge you to think and pray about an area in your life or areas in your life where you know that there is outward disobedience. And if you can't find anything, then you pray David's prayer. Search my heart, O God, know me. Try me, see if there is any wicked way within me, and lead me to the way everlasting. Ask him to show you hidden things about yourself that you may not know of, that are not brought to your awareness. But where there is obedience, there is anointing. Because salvation is free, but anointing and calling, that's what costs you something. Today I want to encourage you. What is that area or areas in your life that are keeping you from the anointing and calling that God has placed on your life. Because you're not to live a life, if you're a child of Christ, without power. We are world changers. We are life and humanity influencers. And if you're doing anything less than that on a day-to-day basis, you're not walking in the full authority that as a child of God is your inheritance. And I encourage you today, because there's lots of people and lots of things on the other side of the coin that are walking in their full authority. We need to take our place as daughters and sons of God and walk in our full authority and our full power, knowing who and whose we are. And the first step to doing that is obedience. I love you guys so much. I'm praying for you. I'm proud of you. Today, make sure that you spread faith, not fear, love, not germs, be a blessing in a stranger's life, because that is how we change the world. And I'll see you in the next one.